new sci-fi drama that is now streaming on Apple TV Plus. I believe it's been streaming there for the last few days at least. I can't remember exactly when this movie came out. This film is directed by Miguel Sapochnik, or Sapochnik. I'm not really sure how you're supposed to pronounce that. And for the average person, most of you are not gonna know who this guy is. I mean, I think this is his second film that he's ever directed. He directed a film called Repo Men a few years ago, but if you're a Game of Thrones fan, then that name should feel very familiar to you, because this guy has directed like 5 or 6 of the greatest episodes of Game of Thrones we ever saw. I mean, hello, Battle of the Bastards, anybody? This guy directed that episode. This film also stars Tom Hanks and Caleb Landry Jones and a really cute doggy whose name, unfortunately, I did not get, but I'm gonna look up his name after this review is over. So this is a post-apocalyptic story. Tom Hanks plays a scientist who's kind of living and surviving in the ruin of the old world with his dog. Eventually, he learns that he is dying because of an exposure to radiation, and so he creates and invents a robot with artificial intelligence that is meant to take care of his dog after he has passed away. What follows is kind of a cross-country trip of sorts where Tom Hanks has to discover some stuff about himself that maybe he didn't know while bonding with this robot, but also the robot is going to discover a bunch of stuff about life and humanity that he didn't know. And you know, it's one of those type of stories. I'll be honest, I kind of stumbled upon this movie by accident. It was late one night, I was playing Ghost of Tsushima, I got bored, I wanted to watch a movie. Then I was scrolling through each of my streaming apps and I couldn't really settle on anything. I went on Apple TV Plus and I remember I had just finished catching up on Foundation, so I wanted to see if they had anything else to watch. And then I saw Tom Hanks and I was like, holy shit, Tom Hanks, I wonder what this movie's about. And so I put the movie on and I figured, hey, at least if it's shit, I'll probably get a good night's sleep out of this. Luckily, I am here to tell you that the movie, in fact, did not put me to sleep. In fact, I actually really enjoyed this one. I gotta get the obvious out of the way. This is a very familiar and I guess somewhat tired premise. Like, you've definitely seen this type of story and you've heard these type of story beats before. Tom Hanks, who's basically in the movie by himself or with a robot for the majority of the movie, that's gonna remind a lot of people of Castaway. Obviously, you look at other like robot movies where robots have to like discover their humanity. You look at Wally, you look at Chappie. This movie, by the way, is way better than Chappie. I mean, there's a human, a robot, and a dog. I'm pretty sure that's like every fifth movie that comes out has some of those ingredients in it. Like every fifth movie, Tom Hanks is acting his ass off. Every fifth movie, there's a dog that you get to root for. And every fifth movie, there's a robot that gets to find out what the fuck's so special about being human. A very familiar premise, but sometimes, like I've said in the past, it's not about how familiar the premise is. It's about how well it's executed. And that's really what this movie has to stand on. It has to stand on solid workmanlike execution. There's nothing I can say about Tom Hanks that you haven't heard before. Tom Hanks is one of our goats. He's great. He could do anything in a movie. It doesn't really matter how good or bad the movie is. Tom Hanks is gonna be great. There's nothing I can say about him that you haven't already heard before. He's actually kind of a dick in terms of how his character is written, so it kind of takes a little while to warm up to him. You do eventually find out why he is a dick, but I'm just saying, you don't usually see Tom Hanks playing a dick in a movie, but you know, it was kind of fun to watch. And Caleb Landry Jones is the one who supplies the voice of the robot in this movie. The robot's name is Jeff for the purposes of the film. And I like the bond that he and Tom Hanks form over the course of the movie. Obviously, you've seen robots and humans have better chemistry before. Hello, we've seen Terminator 2, right? If you haven't seen Terminator 2, I mean, to be honest, you shouldn't be watching YouTube videos at all. Like, that's an essential movie for growing up in this world. Like, go watch Judgment Day, like right now. Also, the doggy was such a good boy in this movie. Such a good boy. I love the doggy. The dog was awesome. Movies with dogs are awesome. Can we just agree on that? A couple of thrills here or there, but ultimately this is not an action movie. This is really a drama movie that's meant to develop these characters and really push you on this journey in this post-apocalyptic world. It's just one of those consistent type of feel-good type of movies that's got some humor, it's got some heart. It combines it in a story that's easy to follow and easy to root for some of the people in this movie. Like I said, familiar premise, the same thing that I was kinda sorta praising it about in the positive section, I am now going to tear down in the negative section, because we gotta be somewhat negative about movies, don't we? All of the familiar tropes of the genre, you've seen them before. You've seen them in better movies even, so nothing about this movie is gonna be earth-shattering. It's not gonna reinvent the wheel. The movie has a very predictable ebb and flow to it. You know what's gonna happen before it happens and yada, yada, yada. Like, that's something I have to say for the review. It didn't bother me much, but it's gonna bother other people. I do think this movie does suffer from some pacing issues, and that's because a lot of the times it feels like the plot here is kind of meandering. Like, It's kind of just aimless and doesn't really have a real direction that it's going. There is motivation in the movie for these characters and what they're doing, but you just feel like it's kind of pointless at the end of the day. It's just a 2-hour sci-fi drama where you just feel like there's not really a lot of stakes beyond the human and the dog and the robot. And if that's good enough for you, then cool. I think it's one of the more underrated movies that you're probably not gonna see unless you have Apple TV Plus. And I'm not trying to get in their subscriber pockets. I'm just saying, I don't know that many people that are subscribed to Apple TV Plus. Hey, if you get a chance to watch it on Apple TV Plus or you get a chance to illegally download it, I'm not judging. I just think that you might have a good time watching this movie. Finch was actually a pretty fun time. It did not put me to sleep. I'm gonna leave this one in the Silver Age for Man of Steel. Tell me what your top 5 favorite Tom Hanks movies are, or tell me what some of his worst performances are. Give me those in the comment section. I'm actually kind of curious about people's opinions on Tom Hanks nowadays. Please like and subscribe to the Superfan Show, and if you like what you see, tell me how you feel and stay tuned to hear more from the Man of Steel. This video is also sponsored by Dune, courtesy of the Paul Atreides Funko Pop. Yeah, let's cut.